soldiers, sailors, and airmen of the Allied Expeditionary Force. You are about to embark upon the great crusade toward which we have striven these many months. The eyes of the world are upon you. The hopes and prayers of liberty-loving people everywhere march with you. In company with our brave allies and brothers in arms on other fronts, you will bring about the destruction of the German war machine, the elimination of Nazi tyranny over the oppressed peoples of Europe, and security for ourselves in a free world. Your task will not be an easy one. Your enemy is well-trained, well-equipped, and battle-hardened. He will fight savagely. But this is the year 1944. Much has happened since the Nazi triumphs of 1940-41. The United Nations have inflicted upon the Germans great defeats in open battle, man to man. Our air offensive has seriously reduced their strength in the air and their capacity to wage war on the ground. Our home fronts have given us an overwhelming superiority in weapons and munitions of war, and placed at our disposal great reserves of trained fighting men. The tide has turned. The free men of the world are marching together to victory. I have full confidence in your courage, devotion to duty, and skill in battle. We will accept nothing less than full victory. Good luck, and let us all beseech the blessing of Almighty God upon this great and noble undertaking.
Alrighty guys, let's get to it. Let's get into it. Let's try it out and see what happens. This is more of our combat, standard combat series from Multiman Publishing in the great and wonderful Day of Days here in Vassal. So after our initial paratrooper landing scattered throughout the countryside here in France, we now have to do our beach landings, as we can see here. Did the airdrop, and we did our preliminary bombardment. Now it's up to the landing. So, let's take a look at the landing information found on page 7. Kind of goes over some information ahead of that. The procedure, etc., etc., but there are some specific rules about Utah Beach. The original landings at Utah Beach drifted significantly from the actual objectives. This may happen again in the game. At the beginning of the landing phase of turn one, roll a die on a roll of 1 to 3. Use the actual planned beaches for Utah, Tower Green, and Uncle Red. On a roll of 4 to 6, use the historical beaches that results from the drift factor. The roll of beach hexes will be used for the fouling landings at Utah. Only the beaches actually used can count as a supply source. Note that if Victor is used, the player has his choice of the hexes there to land in. There was no roll to determine the landing hex, as on other beaches during waves 1 and 2, but the units must be distributed as evenly as possible, so each hex has the lowest stacking possible. So, what a big difference is one roll is going to happen. We're either going to be bunched up against these very formidable bunkers, or we're going to be down here. And not only that, but we don't even need to roll. We can just assign units to each of these different locations that come in. So you can see here's wave 1 for that, and here's wave 1 for that. So, I suppose, do I want to get my dice out and roll for this? Now, I think we'll just use Vassal this time so I don't have to get out my camera and everything. So, let's zoom down to the bottom here, and this will just be some practice rolls. There we go. All right, I can type in some text. All right, there we go. All right, here we go. So, 1, 2, or 3, we're going to end up using Tar Green and Uncle Red. 4, 5, 6, we're going to use Victor. Let's see what a big difference this is going to make. It is a 5! Oh, Nelly! Holy cow, that is going to change everything. So all these guys are going to drift down. And not only that, but we can assign who goes to which location. Let's just make sure there's no other special rules about landing, the pulmonary bombardment, the landing procedure. Da 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 da. No, I think not. Okay, I think we're good to go. I don't see anything anyways. So, what are we going to do? We're going to have to stack these up. We're going to put them... let's see, how do we want to do this? Do you want to have our good, all our good units in one hex? Probably not. Let's kind of separate. Oops. Tank, tank, tank. Let's put our mortar here with an infantry. Another infantry. And another mortar, huh? All right, so we'll put two mortars. I'm gonna try and bomb this area so we can kind of maybe try to get in through there, I'm thinking. So yeah, so that is that. Now comes the danger. Danger, danger, danger. Fortunately, we got three or less in each stack, so we won't have the penalty. Now comes the German barrage, so hold on to your hats, boys and girls. So we're going to get out all the barrage markers for the Germans. You can see it highlight all of the units with pink. So let's start up here to the north. So this guy's only got a range of 3, so he won't do anything. This guy's got a range of 20. He will. This guy's got a range of 3. If I click on this guy, does it get rid of all the other... Ah, it does. Damn it. All right, so this guy will be able to barrage. Range of 3. No. You can't make it. What do you got in there? Range of 2. Range of 30. Okay, he will be able to barrage. I'm just going to stack up all the ones that can barrage. And then we'll figure out where they need to go. 16, he'll be able to barrage. 16. 16. Let's see. The only units that can be actually targeted, that is one point in the rules here. I should probably bring up. Let's see. I think it's in barrage, actually. I think it's under the barrage section. Might be in landings. Let's see, where is it? But basically it says, on turns 1 and 2, only units that arrive on the beach can come under attack. Let's see, where was that? Airdrops new. Where is it? Come on now. Well, I think you guys might just have to trust me. So this is kind of important here. During turns 1 and 2, only allied units which have landed via naval landings, airdrop, can move, barrage, attack, or be the targets of German barrages. There we go. Right there's what I was looking for. So only units that arrived by naval landings can move, barrage, attack, or be the targets of German barrages. So there you go. See, now you don't have to believe me. All right. This guy only has a range of 3. He won't make it. This guy's got a range of 16 now. Let's see. Is he going to be in range? Where is these down here? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. Oh, he will make it. But we will have to see. I don't think he can reach up there, can he? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. Yeah, he can. Okay, so he can make it anywhere. Okay, that's great. He's got a range of 3. Nope. Range of 3. Nope. Range of 16. He can make it. Range of 16. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Yeah, he'll make it. Good Lord. Range of 2. Range of 16. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16. So he can't target the guy at the top, but he can target anybody else. So he will make it as well. Good Lord. There's going to be a lot of barrages coming our way. A lot of barrages. So we have 2, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So we're just going to go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. And then each one of these, bunch of diggies. Each one of those can only barrage. If we look at that rule, it is strong points. A given target X can only be barraged by up to 3 artillery, naval, and strong units, and 2 airstrikes. No more than 3 friendly artillery, naval, and strong point units can ever barrage a given hex. It's somewhere in here about the strong points have a range of 4 whenever units are on the beach. Somewhere. Let's see here. Oh boy. Maybe it's right here where. Damn, where is it? It's got to be in the barrage section. It's got to be. Oh, here it is. Strong points can spot any beach hex at or within 4 hexes. Strong points require a strong point unit to be as a spotter. So they will still be able to. So this guy will be able to spot anybody here, and then so he can target. So we'll just have him target this X, but how many is it? That's 3. He will target this X. He will target this X. Nope, that's too many. I think the most they said was 3, right? So I think that's 3 for everyone. Oh wait, that's 4. That's 3. Yeah, so I think they're gonna have a few wasted because they just have too many. You can only do up to 3, right? That's the rule, right? Artillery can barrage it's adjacent to an enemy unit. Spotter does not have to be adjacent for the following. Units on hills and a strong point can spot any beach hex at or within 4 hexes. Yeah, I don't think it's going to matter because I think they're going to have enough attacks anyways. But anyways, what we were looking for was... Oops, that's not what I wanted. I want this. Good Lord. No more than three friendly artillery, naval, and strongpoint units can ever barrage a given hex in any single phase. There you go. All right, so we'll start with this hex right here. Let's pull these three counters off. All right, so first one here from the 10/101st. That's going to be this strong point over here. It's only got a range of 2. So this guy isn't going to actually be able to do anything. So I'm going to range it 2. So 1, 2, 1, 2. This guy will be able to. Okay, and then this one here, we can jump in there. There we go. All right, so we're still going to get our 3. All right, so 1 or 2, he's going to hit. There is modifiers, which is the terrain effect chart. Beach is a -1. And I believe those are all beach hexes down there. Yeah. So he's going to get a -1, and he needs 2. So 1 or 2 or 3. Rolls a 6, so no effect. This guy is a 1 or 2, so he needs 1, 2, or 3. 5, no effect. Good, good, good so far. This guy here, 2. So he will hit, which will DG all these guys. Disrupt them. I'm not sure why it's... okay, whatever. Just set these aside for a minute. And because he disrupted these guys, now he can try a kill number. And since he is a... So here is, if it's got a yellow code, it's 4 or higher. If it's a German 88 or a Song Point, it's 5 or higher. Any others is 6 or higher. So he is a 5 or higher. Let's see if he hits. 1. No, so he doesn't, I mean, he disrupts his units, but he doesn't kill them. So that's good. Now these guys. Again, he's got too many in there. He can only have 3. 1, 2, 3. All right. So pull. All right. Let's try that again. All right. Guy in the top. 1 or 2. -1 because he's on the beach. 2. He's hit. So these guys all become DG. Give me a thing. Thank you. And now, because he's a strong point, 1 or 5 or 6, he'll cause damage. 4. Nope. Sorry, buddy. This guy is a 2. This one's coming in from a long ways away. He's a 2. -1. 1, 2, or 3. He rolled a 2, so he would DG, but he does get a kill. And he's a yellow unit. So 1, 2, 3, or 4, and that's trouble. 4. He's going to... he's going to cause a damage here. Let's flip over this infantry unit here. We are going to flip it. So it does some damage as it lands. This guy here is a 3, so 1, 2, 3, 4, it'll hit. He's rolled a 5. Oh, too bad for you, buddy. All right, so that's not horrible. We didn't completely get killed. All right, let's see what's over here now. All right, so we got a lot of artillery coming in from a long ways away. 16 X's, 16 X's, 20 X's. So these guys are hearing... All right, so first guy here, 1, 2, 3, or 4 will be a hit, and it's a 2, so he's going to disrupt all those guys. I'll put that on in a minute. And now he's a yellow unit, so 1, 2, 3, or 4, he'll do some damage. I'm sorry, 4, 5, or 6, he'll do some damage. He rolled a 2,
So what do we have? I guess we'll flip that guy. So this did some damage. So this is 1, 2, or 3 because they're on the beat. 3, damn. So he would just DGS, but because he had, he gets a chance at a kill. And again, because he's a yellow unit, 4, 5, or 6. 4, damn, another hit. So another infantry unit flips. And the last guy, 1, 2, or 3. 4, okay, well. So far, it hasn't been horrible. Now these guys are all, let's go ahead and copy this, clone it, there we go. So these guys are all DG. Now, what do we have over here? Got some more artillery coming up. I think all this, most of this artillery is coming from down over here in this general area. All right, so first guy, 1, 2, 3, because he's on a beach. 4, he misses, good. This guy's a 1, 2, or 3 again. 1, he's hit. So that'll DG everyone. And he'll get a kill number, 4, 5, or 6. 6, and we'll take it off of this infantry. And the last guy, 1, 2, or 3, he hits, and 4, 5, or 6, he'll kill, and he'll kill. So these guys down at the bottom got hammered. But all in all, I think that was okay, to be honest. We didn't get totally destroyed. And that'll be interesting. All right, so let's go ahead and send all of the spotted counters back to there. There we go. Did I grab? I must have moved this guy instead of his spotting round. I'm not sure where he. 47. Oh, that's where he is currently. All right. Well, I'm not sure where he came from. We're going to assume he was down here somewhere. We'll just put him down here. That's fine. So I must have moved him instead of the little spotting round. I could look it up, and I might, in between episodes, but there's no sense in wasting time doing that right now, because it's not going to make that big a difference. All right, so that was a German barrage. Now we got Allied movement. Again, special rules on that. There's going to be a lot of special rules on the first two turns, because they're special turns. So there's going to be a lot of special rules. So, all right. So, somewhere it says that they can only move one hex. I'll find it for you. Might have been up here somewhere. Let's see. Now, where was it I read that they can only move one space? Might be here. Allied units may only move one hex during the movement phase on these two turns. It may advance after combat. Normally, the only German activity in these two turns are the barrages done in the specific German barrage phase. Turn 3 starts our normal turn 3, which includes the third landing wave, is a full game turn using the regular sequence of play. So there you go. So turns 1 and 2 are special. All right, so where are we? We are in Allied movement. Righto. We can only move one hex. Well, we want to get these guys off the beach. We want to get these guys off the beach. We want to get these guys off the beach. We want to move these guys off the beach. Get them all off the beach, right? Allied barrages. All right, so we had a couple mortar units here. So we have a couple mortar units. So the first... Ooh, so that's a good question. Do we want to try and mortar this, or do we want to try to take this out? I think we just have the two mortar units, but we have some more coming in turn number two. These mortar units just will damage on a six, so it's, we need both of them to hit, both of them to kill, just to knock this thing out. This enemy unit's already DG'd. Yeah, I think we'll, I think both of our mortars are going to go for here, so I'm not going to get out the little spotting rounds and everything. We're going to go for this one here. Alright, so three or less on the first one, all the way to the left there, the D/1. Guess this guy there. Alright, so three or less. Two, he hits. Now we need a six. Six! No! Damn it. Alright, and then the other mortar unit, three or less. Six. Oh, there's the six we needed. Damn it. So he misses. Or, well, he doesn't do any effect. The strong point can't become disrupted, it doesn't really matter. The unit that's in there, though, is disrupted. Now, what's after the barrage? Then we have the Allied combat phase. So we could have this infantry unit attack. That would not be a good choice, though. Not with that strong point there. Good lord. Five defense. Four for the infantry. Right? I am reading that right. If I recall correctly, it should go attack. Yeah, attack value, then defense value, then movement. Right. That would not be a very good attack. That would be a, well, we'd be attack of two, but because we're DG, we'd halved. That would take us to one. and we're in a flooded area, which means attack is half, so he'd be a half a point against his defense of 5 and 4 is 9. So it'd be a half versus 9. That would be the worst odds you could possibly get. And you can see that would cause a lot of damage to us. Not great. All right, so no, we choose not to attack. Maybe if we get some more units in here, we can do something, but good lord, that is... Wow. All right, now what? So, Allied Combat, and then I think that's the end of the... Let's see. So when do you take off? During the DG removal phase, as long as units are not overstacked, any DG marker in overstacked hexes remains. So, when is the DG removal phase? Alright, so... So, we have the winner. So, we don't have that, actually, in the first two turns. Wow, that's... That's gonna be rough. Alright, let's see where we're at. So, we're done with... Wave 1. Now we go on to Wave 2. There is no allied airdrop. That's turn 1 only. There's no preliminary bombardment. That's turn 1 only. There's landings. So I guess we go to the landings. So we got a new destroyer comes in. And it's going to go right there, actually. And then we have all these units here. What do we have coming in here? We got three infantry, a mortar, and a mortar. We also have, wow, we got this really good, that yellow mortar. It's got a range of 12 hexes. So as long as we have somebody with a blue stripe adjacent to these guys. He should be able to... Alright, so... Let's put our mortar there. Do we have any... Another mortar. We'll put him there. Infantry, okay. Put this guy back over there. Here's another mortar. I'm trying to separate these guys out a little bit, I guess. Alright, so we got one, two, three. One, two, three. One, two, three. One, two. All right, there's landings. Oh, God. Here we go again. German barrage from a million miles away. Guess the best thing to do is do this again. I think that's the best way to do it. So he's too far away. Oh, good Lord, what did I do? Undo whatever you just did. All right, this guy can make it, this guy can make it. This guy again, this guy again. He can't make it, he can't make it, this guy can. He can't make it. He can make it though. And this guy can make it. And this guy can make it. I think that's everyone. So that is 2, 4, 6, 8. 8. So again, we're just going to go 1, 2, 3, 4. We're going to go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So that'll be 3 there. That'll be 3 there. This guy will go here. This guy will go here. This guy can go a range of 2. So he's going to go 1, 2. This guy can go a range of 2, so he'll go 1, 2. This guy will be out of range, and this guy will be out of range. So that should maximize the German bombardment as best as we can. Three, 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 two. So I'll tell you what, let's do 2-2. Do 3-3-2-2. There we go. All right. That's a lot of bombing. All right. So now they, at least we're not on the beach, though. Oh, so that is a point. Hang on a second. Do they want to try and bomb the guys on the beaches? Oh, wait. You know what? They have to bomb the guys on the beaches. What am I thinking? In the first two turns, they can only target the guys on the beach. Right. So, silly little rules that you have to remember, right? Alright, so I'll put these behind. There we go. Alright, so you guys go up there and you go there. Alright. Whew, serious bombardment. Boy, you feel for those guys on the beach now. They make it to the beach and then they just get blown up. And these are guys that are not even in front of any of the bunkers. Just think if you would have landed there at the bunker. You got guys shooting you from these bunker locations. You got artillery coming in from all over the place, just landing everywhere. Oh my gosh. All right. So these guys will be on the beach. So he's a 1 or 2, minus 1 because he's on the beach. 1, 2, or 3. He got a 3, so he's DG'd. Now he gets to try to kill with a 4 or 5. It's a 3, so no kill. Good. This guy's a 1, 2, or 3 again. 6, so no damage. So these guys are going to land without taking any, they did take a hit. Unfortunately, they took a hit. So we got to clone this DG. What did I just clone? I wanted to clone the DG marker, please. Not you guys. All right, so let's clone this about a million times. There we go. All right, we'll just set these over there. Oh, shoot. God. Undo. All right. Yeah, these are the guys that go here, dummy. I deleted those guys, and I shouldn't have deleted them. What I meant to do was take this DG marker. Now I can clone it. Okay, almost messed up there and deleted units coming in. That would have been bad. And we'll just make a couple stacks. All right. So because that first unit hit, they will become DG, unfortunately, because otherwise they could have, you know, been in good shape, but no. All right, next group. I'll do this guy here. 1, 2, or 3, because they're on the beach. 6. Wah, wah, wah. Good. This guy's 1, 2, or 3 as well. 2. Oh, we hit. All right. So that DG's everybody. And because he's a yellow guy, 4, 5, or 6 will take a step loss. Oh, damn it. We'll take a step loss there. Flip him. All right, and that's not too bad. All right, this guy's a 1, 2, or 3. 5, nothing. Good, good, good. This guy's a 1, 2, 3, or 4. Damn. 1, that's a hit. So he'll DG everyone. Now he needs a 4, 5, or 6. Ugh. He's going to do some damage there. Flip him. All right, and then this guy's a 1, 2, or 3, 4. All right, so they missed 2 of the 3. We'll take that. And last but not least, oof. All right, what do we got here? We got a go 2, 1, 2, or 3 for a hit. No, it's a 5. You missed 1, 2, or 3 for this guy. 1, you hit. And he's a yellow unit, so 4, 5, or 6. No, no damage. This guy's a 1, 2, 3, or 4. No, he rolls a 5. Wow. They ended up hitting just one dime, which is huge, but they didn't do any damage. Wow. That was amazing. Good result there for the Americans there. All right, we can put those all back. That was a lot of bombardment, but not a lot of damage. Not a lot there. We got one guy that took damage there. One guy that took damage there, and nobody that took damage there. That's pretty good. So we landings, we did the German barrage, now we got the Allied movement. Well, let's just start moving some more, guys. Again, they can only move one hex. So do we move here? Well, we know this guy's going there. We know this guy's probably going to go here. We know this guy's probably going to go there. This guy's got to move up. This guy's got to move up. This guy's got to move up. Yep, I guess we can only go one space. Once turn 3 starts, then we can start moving a little bit. But all right, so that was Allied movement. We got really lucky on that bombardment, I have a feeling. So that was movement. Allied barrages now. Right. So we got barrages here from this unit way down here in the south. We have these two units. We have a unit there. We have two units here. One, two, three. All right, so what we'll do is we got to assign these first. Oh no, they have to be adjacent, don't they? Damn. They have to be adjacent. You have to have somebody adjacent. So I guess everyone is going to go for this guy because he's the only guy we can see. Oh, you know what we forgot to do in this is the destroyers as well. Now the destroyers don't need to have anyone. They can just target anybody they want. So we have the destroyer. I think it's just the 3 of them. If I remember correctly. It's just 3 of them. All right, so we're going to go 1, 2, 3. Just one there. Then all of our guys are going to target this guy. All right, so first destroyer, the DD-34. 1, 2, or 3, let's get a hit. 2, it's a hit. Because he's a yellow. 4, 5, or 6 will take him a step loss. Come on, baby. Give it to us. Yes! So flip that bad boy. So now we got the DD-20. It's going after this guy. 1, 2, or 3 will hit. 5. Oh, he misses. And this guy, DD-119-60. Gonna go for this guy. He needs a 1, 2, or 3. Hit. And because he's yellow, 4, 5, or 6 will destroy it. Yes! It is destroyed, sent to graveyard. So we've got an opening, boys. We got an opening. All right, now let's see what we can do down here. So let's... We got a 3 and a 3. All right, so we'll just do this hex first. So, you know what? Wait a minute. We can only do 3 attacks, right? Yeah, that's right. So we're going to take our 3 biggest attacks, which is this guy here. Because he's a yellow. Do we have any other yellows? No. 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 But we will take our 4s, though, because they're easier, better chance to hit. Where are they? So I got a 4 there. That's the 87th Chem. Got the 87th Chem. We'll take our yellow guy here. And I think everyone else is a 3. All right, so let's start with our good guy. He's a 1, 2, or 3 for a hit. 1, 2, or 3. Come on. Yes! And because he's a yellow unit, 4, 5, or 6 will do some damage. Yes! Excellent. Flip that bad boy. All right, good job. Then we're going to take the 87 Chem. 1, 2, 3, 4 will hit. Oh, you suck. And yeah, I think the rest of the guys are all about equal. So we'll just, doesn't matter. We'll just choose this guy here. 1, 2, or 3. No. Oh, that's a bummer. But we, if we could have destroyed that guy, that would have really helped. But look at his defenses went way down. He's still got that infantry unit in there, which is not going to be nice. But he'd be a 7 defense. Again, not the greatest because we got all our units are DG'd right now, which is not great. I think. Yep, that was our barrage just now, if we had any combat. But I don't think we're going to do any combat. I don't think... we got a couple of units, finally. 3, a 2, and a 3, but half of that's going to be... 3, 6, 7, 8, so that would be 4. And then because we're in a flooded area, we lose half, so that's 2. And then this guy is a 3, 1.5. So it'd be like 5.5 to 7. Almost 1-to-1. Yeah, it was probably be. I think that would probably be a 1-to-1 chart. Let's see what the 1-to-1 is on. Where's our chart? 1-to-1 is still not great. Even a 2-to-1 is not great. Obviously, it depends on what you roll, but still. Alrighty, well, that is the landings from the first turn, the second turn. We got really, I hate to say it, but I think we got kind of lucky on our location. And as I said in the first episode, you know, you can play this scenario 5 times, 10 times, right? You're never going to get the same results because... all your paratroopers are going to go different locations. We didn't get the, we didn't get the air support. Did we forget the air support? Or is that just in? airstrikes, right. That's on the first turn. What about... I guess we get no airstrikes the second time around. It says to use this. And I don't think the airplanes are part of the artillery. When do weather, reinforcements, airdrops, landings, road march, movement, DG removal, Allied barrage, German barrage, combat, exploitation, and supply? I remember reading something that every turn, yeah, right here, of airstrikes. But that's under preliminary bombardment of phase of turn one. The Allied player conducts any available airstrikes. These attacks may only target hexes containing a strong point or other NA units. And it goes right into then landing units. Doesn't talk anything about that. I guess not. I mean, we don't do that on turn two. We don't do that on turn two. We just do the landings. The German barrage, the Allied movement, the Allied barrage, and then the Allied combat. I'm sure somebody will let me know if we're doing it wrong. I'm sure somebody will let us know. All right, well, anyways, I appreciate everyone coming out tonight. Checking a little more of our... Oh, yes. We need to save this game. Let's save this as we're done with 2B now. Done with 2. Turn 2. On to turn 3 now. We're going to go to, like, normal turns. So that means all of our units get to activate now. We don't get our dispersed... paratroopers until turn 4, but the rest of them get to do things, so maybe they can start coming in and targeting some of these artillery units that are keep bombing our men on the beach coming in. And we do have a lot of guys coming in turn 3. A lot of guys with really good artillery there. Lots of good artillery. If we can keep these guys alive, that would be great. We just need to get some guys up because we need people to spot for them. So we blew a hole, and a couple other of the strong points are weakened. We got this one German infantry unit in there, which is being a real pain. If it wasn't for him, we might be able to take over that hex, but things should start ramping up pretty insane next turn. You can see we are breaking out. We need to get out of all this flooded area too. Look at that. I mean, it's just a, if we zoom out a little bit, this flooded area is kind of bad. Makes it for, you get half strength when you're trying to attack out of that flooded area. So we need to start breaking out in the regular bocage areas. Alrighty, guys. Well, thank you all for joining me. I do appreciate it. We will see you all very, very soon. Until then, take care. That has been Day of Days, the Standard Combat Series. And I'm actually expecting my game Day of Days in the mail tomorrow with a bunch of other goodies. So we'll be doing a live unboxing when that package arrives tomorrow. So hopefully we'll see you guys then. Until then, have a good night, guys. We'll see you tomorrow.